The African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement, signed in 2018 by African countries, creates a single African market for over 1.3 billion consumers. Despite the fact that the policy has been ratified in a number of countries, women engaged in cross-border trade say they still face hostility in other countries while doing business. During today's CSO consultative meeting on women and youth on the protocol operating along the Katuna, Mutukula and Busia borders, it was noted that there is still unfair treatment in other countries.
Partner states are not honoring the agreement they made. You see people closing borders. You see people banning what? Goods from partner states to enter the what? Without a genuine reason. So we need to address, to get familiar, to close the gaps, to bridge them before you go to the what? To the ocean.
You're telling us you're always negotiating, but the negotiations does not end. And we don't always get the feedback, what is coming out of the negotiation. Take an example. We had a scenario of maize in Busia. Negotiations were taken, maybe it's lately, it was addressed. Now, it's the eggs now. People are reacting. People are complaining about the sale. Take another scenario of Katuna. It's now but a dream. We will never know whether the border will ever be open.
For many business people operating across borders, challenges like trade liberalization, non-tariff barriers, among others, are almost pushing them out of business. Yet, according to CSOs, regional trades are the only way to increase business profitability.
Where we are losing out is the issue of language barrier. We have moved in the EAC. Unfortunately, Uganda is lagging behind because of Kiswahili. So we also have a few programs going forwards where we are going to try and ensure that we get teachers to teach Kiswahili, because recently when we were in Mwanza, we saw scenarios where there's a complete communication gap between some people from, for example, Zanzibar and some from Uganda, and they actually want to buy. They really want to buy, but you have to get an interpreter.
Our government actually channels a lot of money in education, specifically around acquainting our people, our youth, our women, with the knowledge of the CFT and how best they can perform. Is the only way we will harness from this amazing treaty.
Georgina Mugera, the principal commercial officer at the Ministry of Trade, says there's need for a trade protocol, especially for youth and women, to enhance their participation in cross-border trade.
When we talk about gender, we are talking about both men, women, and the youth. So we do consider that these are key groups in our economies that boost our trade. And ideally, the agreement does recognize that. And that is why we are going to develop a protocol on gender and the youth. So it is a bit critical for us to appreciate that bit.
Siatin Uganda, in its new strategic plan 2021, is implementing a program on women and youth economic empowerment to influence gender-responsive trade. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.